Hello everyone, today we are going to start our next module, that is consolidation of soil. In your syllabus, it is mainly confined to one-dimensional consolidation theory. So we are not going to discuss the three-dimensional consolidation theory, we are just going to confine within one-dimensional consolidation theory. So let us start. What is consolidation? When a compressive load is applied on a soil mass, a decrease in volume takes place. So this decrease in the volume of soil mass under the stress is generally termed as compression. And the property of the soil mass pertaining to its susceptibility to decrease in volume under the pressure is known as compressibility. So when the voids of the soils are filled with air only, compression of soil generally occurs rapidly because the air is compressible and can be escaped easily from the void. But in case of any saturated soil mass having its voids filled with an incompressible water, decrease in volume or compression can take place when water is expelled out of the voids. Such compression resulting from a long-term static load and the escape of pore water pressure is generally termed as consolidation. So what is basically consolidation? It is a gradual reduction in the volume of a either partly or fully saturated soil under sustained loading, and it is mainly due to the expulsion of water from the pores of the soil. So if a static load is applied on a soil, the load is first carried out by the pore water, and this sudden increase in pore water is known as excess pore pressure. And this buildup of excess pore pressure causes the water to drain out of the pores and allows the soil skeleton to compress and get stressed. This excess pressure is gradually transformed from water to the soil particle as effective pressure. The equilibrium occurs when all the excess pressure in the water is transferred to the soil skeleton as effective pressure and no more water drains out. So this process of expulsion of water from the soil due to excess pore pressure with gradual reduction in volume of the soil accompanied by transfer of pressure from water to the soil particle is the process of consolidation. So next we will going to study what are the stages of consolidation. Normally there are three stages of consolidation as compression. The first stage is known as initial consolidation. What happens in initial consolidation? It is comparatively a sudden reduction in the volume of soil on the application of the load, mainly due to the expulsion and compression of the air present in the soil pores. So initially the pressure which is applied on the soil mass, due to that pressure, the sudden compression that takes place by the expulsion of air is known as initial consolidation. What is primary consolidation? It is a main phase of compression due to the expulsion of the pore water and dissipation of excess pore pressure. The mechanism that we said earlier, this is the primary consolidation part where the water is being expelled out due to increasing pore water pressure. And it is a time settlement phenomena. So if we can relate to the figure, we can see that as we have previously studied in soil mechanics 1, that water, air and solid, these three phases are present in any soil. So if we considered the change in volume after application of stress, we can easily see in figure number A that before compaction the value of the volume of air was certain amount and it reduced to a bit. That is, there is a reduction in volume of delta V after compaction. That is, this is the primary stage where, this is the preliminary initial stage where there is a reduction in the volume of air. after reduction of air, there comes a primary stage where there is only water and solid that are present in the soil. So from there, after primary consolidation, certain amount of water get expelled out of its void, and hence there is a reduction in the volume of water. So delta V in the next diagram is the reduction in the volume of water due to primary consolidation. And the third phase is known as secondary consolidation. What happens in secondary consolidation? After the dissipation of the excess pore pressure and some compression of the soil continues to gradually reducing rate. The soil continue to reduce, or it reduces to a certain volume, but the rate at which it reduces, the rate is very less. So this is a complex process and it takes a huge lot of time. But the compression that takes place after the primary consolidation, so this compression is known as secondary consolidation. So let us now shift to the mechanics of consolidation. So what is the mechanics of consolidation? So before starting mechanics of consolidation, we will see a figure. So this is the figure where the mechanics of consolidation can be easily understood. So what does the figure indicate? This figure indicates a clay layer which has a thickness of 2D. And this clay layer is sandwiched between two layers of sand which serves as drainage faces. So this is a diagram containing a clay layer sandwiched between two sand layers which act as drainage phase. So what happened? Immediately when there is an application of a pressure, suppose we are considering it as delta P, the entire pressure is taken up by the water. Normally the entire pressure which is applied on the soil is taken up by the water present in the pore, which results in causing a excess pore pressure increment, which is also known as hydrodynamic pressure. Here we are representing it as U bar. Thus, at time equals to 0, that means when immediately the compression is occurring, our U bar is equal to delta P. So, at this stage, the pressure is transferred to the soil grain is nil. That means initially when we are applying the pressure increment as delta P, all the pressure is taken up by the pore water, that is U bar, and there is no transfer of pressure to the soil grain. That means the pressure to the soil grain will be nil. And if this transferred pressure is represented by delta P bar, then at time t equals to 0, delta P bar equals to 0, as there is no increase in the effective stress of the soil. But at any time afterwards, suppose a certain time t has been elapsed, then what will happen to the increment? Then the effective stress on the soil grain will be equal to U bar plus delta P bar. That is, with increasing the time, U bar, that is pore pressure, will be decreasing, and delta P bar, which is the effective pressure, will be increasing. This process will continue till U bar becomes 0. That means when there will be no dissipation of pore pressure, or when the consolidation will be get completed, then what will happen? Delta P bar will become delta P bar. Delta P bar will be equal to delta P bar. This value will be equal. That means the total pressure applied on the top of the soil will be effective pressure only. That means water will take no such pressure coming to the soil. So for this case, at time t equals to 0 or t equals to infinity, the excess hydrostatic pressure will immediately fall to 0 at upper as well as at the lower end. Because in this figure, we can see that the water is being permitted from the top as well as from the bottom. That means from the top and the bottom, two-way drainage system is occurring. Hence, from two part, the hydrostatic pressure will be zero. And in the middle of the layer, full hydrostatic pressure will be prevail. That value will be equal to U. Hence, the rectangle ABCD, which you can easily see in the diagram, this rectangle ABCD represents the initial hydrostatic excess pore pressure diagram. So, this is the basic mechanism of consolidation theory.